Hey everybody, this is Dr. Greg Pursley and Dr. Aaron Andrews with Between Two Spines. Today's special guest is the one, the only, Jeff Rawson from The Scout and from Russ Media and from Shipyard.
Keep going, go.
That's it.
Those three things.
Soccer dad. Okay. Master Morel, Mushroom Hunter.
Sure.
Okay, we can keep going.
A lot of hats.
You got a lot of hats.
It's true.
A lot of masks now.
Right? Plenty of masks.
We've got them handy just in case, as you said, in case they come around the virus. That was pretty fun.
So this is our first big social distance between two spines.
Yeah.
Really?
It's kind of interesting. You know,
since it's mandatory now. Yeah. Since it's mandatory and we don't want a bunch of comments.
That's right.
Or why are you guys sitting next to each other?
We're not.
We're not. Look at that. We're socially distanced. And we're indoors. And we're downtown Cape. This is beautiful. I love it. It is 224 degrees outside, I think. Something like that.
Just about.
Instant melt. Instant sweat. So, Jeff, tell us about these stickers real quick, man. You gave me some stickers. One of my favorite things. I like sticking them on my guitar case. And
yeah.
Tell us a little about that.
Yeah, I love stickers. And I think I order a new batch of them about once a week. So,
what kind of stickers? Where from?
From different places. I like the matte finished ones, die cut, so I can do all kinds of crazy designs. But we order a lot with the Scout, so there's a different one that probably comes out about once every 2 weeks.
The Scout. Charm and Muscle.
That's us.
That's me.
That's awesome. You? Charm and Muscle.
Every once in a while. One day I'll be Charm. One day it's Charm, one day it's Muscle. I don't think I've ever combined the two in one day. I'm still waiting on it.
It seems like that might be about 1 o'clock. He's like, I tried to end hustle today. I am done.
I got to do less hustle tomorrow.
Yeah.
More charm, less hustle.
So there's still some people out there for some reason. I don't know how. Maybe they've been living under a rock. They don't know Shipyard, what it is, where it's at, why it is, all that sort of stuff. It's one of my favorite events of the year. And we're a sponsor of Shipyard, actually. PC Welcome Centers is a sponsor of Shipyard, which is awesome. But tell us a little bit about the history of that and you know, what it means to you and the city of Cape and all that.
Yeah, so the Shipyard spun out of the Scout, which we can talk more about. But it was this idea that as when I first moved to town, I heard a lot that people wanted that music festival, that big kind of annual event. So I thought, why not? Let's put it together. So the first one was 2 years ago. You were there. It rained a little bit, year one. And I was basically told that, you know, we consulted with a lot of people. I talked with guys in Los Angeles, Las Vegas, people that organize these big events around the country. And afterwards, they kind of said, you know, if you made it through this year and what you guys dealt with, then you're good. You got the bad, you know, the bad weather, the worst possible circumstances out of the way. Last year was gorgeous, it was beautiful, you know, attendance was great.
But it's exciting too, because Cape used to have the River Fest
right
forever ago, and everyone talks about, oh, I wish they'd bring that back, and yeah, to an extent.
It's definitely a diverse mix of music. You can try to get a little bit of everything. It's also something I want to be really accessible to people, so tickets are pretty cheap. To watch a dozen acts over the weekend. I want it to be something that, you know, we can go hang out, that we can take my 6 and 10 year old daughter to, and they can still have a great time. So we have a kids area, lots of family stuff.
And some of these groups have gone pretty big, which is exciting.
Yeah, absolutely. We've had a couple really hit it big. I know you're a big fan. One of the bands from year one, right here, they pretty much left Shipyard and went on tour with the Black Keys right after that.
That's exactly what happened. And I was invited to go down to, they were playing in Nashville, and I was invited to go down there, and I was like, I'm gonna see if I can make that happen. I said, but if I do that, you know, I want a shout out while you're on stage. He's like, oh, we'll get you up on stage. It's pretty awesome. I was like, yes! And then we couldn't go.
No, the bands are great, and we've had, you know, the goal is to hit those bands that are, you know, they're hustling bands too. They do it for a living. This is their life, is playing music and recording music.
Which are some of the best ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're still into it. They're still making music.
They're hungry. They're road dogs. Like, yeah. American Aquarium tours. Like, God, those guys play like 300 shows a year.
Yeah. My favorite band, Big Head Top of Monsters, they don't care about radio and selling CDs. They just tour.
Yeah.
They put on a hell of a show.
If you have suggestions for anybody you'd like to see, by the way,
bring them on.
Yeah, at Shipyard, we love suggestions. Every time I go see a band, I send it to him. He's probably tired.
No, it's great.
I do the same thing.
It's great. No, I get lots of texts about bands that I know and don't know. It's great.
Well, that's the question a lot of people have is, how do you get these bands? What is the routine, or how do you go from start
Yeah, we start. We work with a booking company out of St. Louis that books the pageant, amphitheaters, you know, the Blue Note, the Polish.
Yeah.
Or not the Blue Note. They book Del Mar Hall.
Oh yeah.
So I got hooked up with them. Basically, I spend a lot of time researching, you know, what's getting played, what's next. We always want that band that's going to be next. And then I basically send them a list of, like, here's 300 bands I really think will play well. And he goes through and says, you can't afford them, you can't afford them, you can't afford them. And then he kind of circles the ones that we have a chance at, based on price, availability. And then you start making offers and trying to see if they're going to be in the area, if you can route them through, you know, if they're on a tour, and we can get on a tour route, that's great.
I know we've had some patients talk about maybe having a single carrier right
there. There you go. If we can get a router.
I saw his Facebook page the other day. I wasn't sure who it was.
Yeah.
So I like
it's because he wears his hat. He looks good.
As long as I can be up there doing something, I'll hold the music.
You can play the triangle.
I'll play the triangle with the cowbell.
That's right.
Yeah.
And then
I have a trombone. I would play a trombone.
No.
Yeah.
No trombone.
Stops at a trombone.
You do have a trombone. I played it before. All right. So tell us a little bit about the Scout, Charm, and Hustle. I get the emails every day. If you want the emails, send me. Or put them in the comment, we will make sure you get on the list. It's pretty awesome. I love how witty it is. I love the wittiness.
Cool, thanks. I'm glad you do. You may be the only one, so I really appreciate that.
If you appease one person.
Now, the Scout was, we started a couple years ago. It was basically to connect everyone here locally with the good things that are happening around us. It's pretty simple. There's lots of good music, good food, great events, incredible people. That's where Charm and Hustle comes from. It kind of describes who we are in the Midwest. Is we're delightful people that work really hard. Such charm and hustle. The Scout's a daily email. It comes out every morning about 8 o'clock, Monday through Friday. It's three quick stories. It's meant to be like a 5-minute read. Something just kind of fun and light to get your day started. Maybe it lets you know what the new restaurant is, where the new food truck is.
Well, I like how you do, there's local stuff, but then you also sometimes bring in something else,
yeah.
You know, that story ties it all together. For
yeah, it's definitely, we try to bring in just positivity from around the world. So. You go to thescoutdaily.com. There's a quick form. You just throw your email address in it. You're in. There's no other forms really. It's one line or in the comments. Get these guys up. I'm sure you get a referral link. You can send them to their surprises. Ambassadors. You get people to sign up. And you get mugs and shirts and stickers and all that stuff.
That's what we want. Mugs and shirts and stickers.
Yeah,
sure. So sign up.
Anyway,
all of our patients need to sign up. They're going to get an email with a link. You don't. Click the link and sign up.
We'll know.
We'll know who did and who didn't. We know.
We have thousands that are going out. We're gonna
if you come in to the office and you hadn't signed up, we'll be like, hey, you didn't click the link. What's the deal?
It's a rare thing. It's a free thing, right? There's no subscription.
No.
I'm not gonna ask you to buy anything except a Scout Pass later.
But the Scout Pass.
It's made to be free.
That's what we're there.
That's right.
Yeah,
about that. That's cool.
Oh, you have one. I have one in my pocket. This is my personal one.
Talk about that. That's awesome.
Yeah, this is just again another branch of the Scout. We write a lot about the great things happening, the cool restaurants, you know, the cool experiences. So this was something we started just about 2 weeks ago. It's a little passport book. You take it around to 32 spots in town. They sign off on it. You get to redeem offers. So there are like. Free margarita at El Sol, buy one get one at Minglewood. You know, a percentage off when you go to Creative U to get, you know, paint pottery. So there's something for everyone. You know, something to eat, something to drink. I think there's a free putt-putt golf at a tea house.
Mm-hmm. I feel like with this desk, I feel like I should take care of this.
I should.
I love
you. Like I was doing with your daughter the other day. There's that sound.
There's the screen.
But with your daughter the other day, I was acting like I was taking notes. Like she's in bed.
I love taking notes. I would go back to school in a heartbeat because I love taking notes, like old school notes. I still do. I hate typing stuff. I like to.
Yep.
I hate writing.
I do too. I'm a notebook person.
Yeah, I always have
notebooks. And that's where that came from, really.
You don't want to.
I always carry around notebooks.
No notes?
I don't write.
I love it.
Yes, that's pretty sweet. Port Cave, Gabriel's, CoinUp, Cantina, Tractors, Kenny Flippin' Burgers, El Sol. Creative View, that's awesome. Sugar Sheet, Pho 8. Oh, I love some meat. Pho 8. Baristas, amazing coffee bar. Bent Creek, you got golf in here.
You just make a little bit harder.
Bonbons, you got bonbons in here.
She has the tag, all those businesses.
Yep,
Top of the Bar, Saffron, J Street Brew Company, Tea House. Katie O'Farrell's. All right, yeah, sorry, Katie. Wibs? Oh, dude, love Wibs. That's good, too.
Yeah, Wibs.
This just makes me hungry.
Shout out to yeah, everybody.
Now I gotta name them all since I've named all of them.
Yeah,
because
someone's gonna be like, you didn't talk about
them. I know, them. Right? Did I miss any of them? I
think there's a soda fountain. Is there a soda? I just saw soda, right?
Spanish Food Farms.
Yeah, yeah.
Buddy's Rolled Ice Cream. He was on a couple of weeks ago. That was awesome. Cass. Doritoville. I think I mentioned him.
This
yeah.
is great TV, man.
It's good.
I mean, I'm
telling you. Everyone loves a good
Mary Jane's. Mary Jane on here, man. It's good. I did play at Mary Jane when they had the bourbon on Broadway.
Right.
That was pretty fun. Let's see. We got free drip coffee. Let's see. And Red Band, yeah.
Yep.
I think I've named them all, man.
Have you?
I don't know, man.
I'm sure you'll get a message.
Oh, Foodio. Free lunch at Foodio. So there you go. I got them all. They're all on there. Look at that.
Riveting. Click on any of them.
Caitlin, good luck. I need one of these. We can lay and tag them on. But anyway, those are awesome things. He's adding a lot to Cape Girardeau downtown scene and bringing a lot of entertainment, you know, and putting it all together, really. Like you said, there's a little bit of everybody in this.
Yeah.
And then the Scout, same thing with the emails. A lot of local stuff, some bigger things that go along with it, or some national things that go along with it. And
yeah, what do you like doing for fun when you're not?
No, this is it, man. That's all
it is. Yeah.
No, it's hanging out with the wife and kids. That's if I'm not here, I'm at home. We've gotten into the cycling recently, so that's the big thing now. Shout out Cycle Works. I keep spending way too much money there. So thanks a lot, guys.
Cycle Works.
Actually, hopefully going to get a bike there after this.
Yeah, what kind of bike?
Looking at a Salsa Journeyman.
Oh, yeah?
So, yeah, we're going to take a little trip this weekend and try to do some riding.
I was just reading today, there's a big shortage on bikes because I guess most of them are made in China and they have stopped importing a ton of stuff. So, a lot of the general
merchandise. Kayaks. I've been trying to buy
a
kayak. There's a
huge
shortage of kayaks.
Yeah, there's a shortage of a ton of general stuff.
Which is great. I'm really excited that everyone's buying bikes and kayaks and going outside.
That's true, too.
That's, if I'm not in my office, I'm out there. That's where you find us.
That's where I am, too. Constantly outside. I was going to say something about a bike. I rode a fat tire bike a couple years ago for the first time, and that was one of the most fun experiences. You've never ridden a fat tire bike.
Did you ride like on the beach, like on the sand or something?
No, I went off-road. We went on a couple trails and stuff, and I used to race motocross when I was about 14. And so my wife won't let me get a dirt bike on a motorcycle, just straight off, kill myself, which I probably would do something stupid to hurt myself. But that's like as close as she was. If it doesn't have a motor, it's fine, but she doesn't know what I do.
She's not watching
it. Yeah, she doesn't know what I do when I go down these hills. I'm like, you know. Well, I pulled up, and a buddy of mine was like, hey, you know, we're going biking, whatever. So I pulled up my bike, and he goes, no, put your bike back in your car, you're going to use this. And I was like, okay, this is a big old fat tire.
And we were all raised in a day and age where it's like, hey, watch this, you know.
Oh, yeah, I still
be careful or whatever.
No, wearing a helmet's been new for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't grow up with helmets, or
check this out. Or I'm going to try this, watch this.
Watch this.
Hold my beer.
That's the old standard.
Yeah.
But anyway, it was a lot of fun. It was really cool to just hit relatively good logs, sticks and stuff, and just no big deal. Whereas I used to have to, you know, hop over and
right.
stuff. Just no big deal. So anyway, it was a lot of fun. I like fat tire bikes. And that's the end of the show. Okay. You're supposed to chime in there.
I was watching baseball first.
Yeah, there is a baseball game. Yeah.
Baseball game from what, late 90s?
It's coming
late.
Soon, yeah.
Yeah.
If you haven't been in here or driven by it, there's a huge screen up here.
It's the
really neat, yeah.
It's the All-Star game from
sometimes.
It's classic, so it's gotta be like at least 9 years ago.
I got distracted because I thought it was.
If there's any better TV than listening to a guy realist, it's watching three guys watching TV.
Yeah, exactly.
You can't see.
Yeah, exactly.
What are they watching?
It's better than screen TV. Here's a trivia question. Who's pitching in the All-Star game?
Yeah.
In the 7th and 8th inning, that would be it. Anyway,
so anything
else
coming up?
Yeah.
Anything else? New coming down the horizon that you want to talk about?
Yeah, so we've got, I mean, Scout Pass just got out. We've got a limited amount of those.
How can we get
those soon? Thescoutpass.com. Thescoutpass.com. $25. You got it. There's about $230 worth of stuff in there. So we've got that. We've got a podcast we started up, the Scout Podcast, comes out every Tuesday, so we just recorded that about an hour ago, Yeah, new a couple new projects coming in the next week or two that are going to be really exciting. Can't talk about those yet.
Ooh,
I'm going to talk to you about them off camera.
Yeah, but keep it for sure.
That's going to be great. Some focus on some other people in our community. That's going to be really cool. Some people that don't get enough credit. So that's a cool project to launch here for the next 2 weeks.
Awesome, man. It's fantastic. Well, I love the value you bring to the community and all the ideas you've had. And of course, it's right up my alley. You know, food and drinks and music. We appreciate you being on and talking for a few minutes. Hopefully we can get a bunch of people signed up for the Scout. It's awesome.
Sure.
And I'm going to take some of these stickers with me and maybe I can throw them around.
I already got them on my Hydroflex.
Look at that.
Nice.
Another tag.
Hydroflex.
That's a big one.
Look, it brings it
maybe
up.
Maybe they can sponsor.
Yeah. Am I the only one that didn't bring my Hydroflex? Because I don't have one.
I was the only one in my family didn't have one. I kept drinking every once in a while.
If I have one of those, it's normally going to be Zarka or anything.
It works.
Now we got to tag the Zarka in there.
Yeah.
Sponsors the tag episode.
This is the tag episode. This one is different restaurants.
Yeah, Taylor's for tomorrow because this goes out Friday.
Yeah, exactly. Other than that, like I said, Dr. Greg Persley, please call me Dr. G, Dr. Aaron Andrews. And we are from PC Wellness Centers in Cape Girardeau, chiropractic physicians. This is Between Two Spines. Here's the spines. Billy's pointing out. There they are. And we are with Jeff Rawson. He's got a lot going on, but the Scout, it's an email. Join that. The Scout Pass, purchase those. They are limited. And there's how much value? You said 230?
Yeah, about 230 bucks.
$230 worth of free stuff in there.
Do it. Just do it. Do it.
All right. And we will see you soon, I guess. We also got to say, because you use Shipyard. So you got to come to Shipyard. Buy tickets for that. It's coming up September of 2021.
We're back.
That's right. We'll be right back.